Hi there, I'm Matt and I've taught high school physics, including pre-AP and AP physics. In this video, we'll be talking about induced EMF and electric fields. First, we'll define what an induced EMF is. Then, we'll define Faraday's law of induction. Lastly, we'll investigate how an induced EMF and the induced electric field are related. In 1831, Michael Faraday and Joseph Henry independently discovered that moving a magnet through a coil of wire induces an electric current. The voltage produced by this induced current is called an EMF or electromotive force. Faraday realized that the changing magnetic flux is responsible for the current, since no current is induced if the coil and magnet are stationary relative to each other. Faraday tried another experiment in which he attached a battery and a switch to a coil of wire wrapped around an iron rod. Another coil was wrapped around the rod and connected to a galvanometer. When the switch was closed, he noticed that a current was present in the second coil, but it quickly disappeared. The same thing happened when he opened the switch to break the circuit. He concluded that as the magnetic field rose to its full strength when the switch was closed, and fell back to zero when the switch was opened, was responsible for the induced EMF. Mathematically, we can say that the induced EMF due to a changing magnetic flux is the negative of the rate of change of the magnetic flux over time multiplied by the number of coils. This is expressed as negative n d phi dt, and the negative sign is needed to provide the correct direction for the induced current. This is known as Faraday's law of induction. When the flux is increasing, the EMF will be negative, and when the flux is decreasing, the EMF will be positive. This also means that when the flux is constant, there is no induced EMF. An EMF can be induced in several ways. As you've already seen, moving a magnet back and forth through a coil is one way. Another way is to move the coil through a magnetic field. A third way is to rotate the coil relative to the magnet. The EMF also induces an electric field in the wires, and it's this field that does the work to move the charges through the circuit. Mathematically, this can be represented by the line integral around the circuit of EdL. This can also be expressed as the opposite of the rate of change of the magnetic flux over time. There's a difference between the electric fields generated by an induced current versus an electrostatic field produced by a fixed charge distribution. An induced electric field is non-conservative because it does work by moving charges through the closed path. Conversely, an electrostatic field is conservative because it does no network over a closed path. Let's take a look at an example problem and apply what we've learned. In this example, we have a coil with a radius of 0.40 meters and a symmetrical magnetic field that decays in magnitude according to the equation B equals 1.25 times e to the power of negative 3t, where B is in Teslas and t is in seconds. We're being asked to find the EMF in the coil at 0.05 seconds. We start by examining our equation for EMF, which has the negative sign, remember, and N for the number of coils. In this example, there's only one coil, which means N equals 1. Our next step is to take the derivative of the equation for the magnitude of the electric field with respect to T, which equals 3.75 times e to the power of negative 3T. N equals 1, so that's why you don't see it incorporated into the derivative. Lastly, all we have to do is substitute 0.05 for t and evaluate, which tells us that the EMF at 0.05 seconds is 3.23 volts. Let's recap what we've learned today. First, we learned that when a magnetic field and a coil are moving relative to each other, there's an induced EMF or electromotive force, which can be measured as a voltage. Then we learned that the change in magnetic flux over time is responsible for the induced EMF. Lastly, we learned that an induced electric field is non-conservative and that it performs work equal to the EMF needed to move a charge around the circuit. Thanks for watching, and be sure to check out more physics videos here on Chegg.